know my sister is waiting for this video, you know, because she knows she can get first pick of the lippies that I declutter. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. It's a bit of a weird angle because today is my lipstick declutter video and yeah. It's a lot. I had my camera setup changed so I could film what I was about to do, and then I remembered that I forgot to film a proper intro. And I like the look very, very much, so I didn't want it to go, well, to waste by only using it in one video. The video where I did the look was a collab video, my Twisted Face Off collab with Kitty J. I will link it down below. I will also link my kind of makeup collection playlist / declutter playlist. I said that I need coffee, yes, with my trusty skull mug. But anyway, let me get everything set up, show you a little bit of the footage of where I stored my lipstick, and then show you. You know, my sister is waiting for this video, you know, because she knows she can get first pick of the lippies that I declutter. Anyway, let me change the setup, show you real quick where everything is stored now, and then get on with the declutter, because I need to declutter my lippies. Yeah, I have a problem, people. So, okay, so let me kind of show you where I keep my lippies. So I have some there, and I also have, let me zoom you out, a closet here, lippies. Lippies, more lippies, but you know, most of it I don't use. I also have here lippies. I have some there. So let me grab them. Don't mind the towel because it's a little bit dirty. I used it this morning, but I also had some lippies strewn around the place that I grabbed. Those are here, and I would like very much if I could fit a lot of them in this. I have one of these, but it does not really matter because I can get more. But that is my goal, to kind of have maybe this thing, which I thought was handy, but it's actually not, for, I don't know, stuff that I have in there now. So yeah, let's get decluttering then, shall we? So guys, here you see everything. I have my liquid lipsticks here. Then let me kind of turn the camera a little bit. Just a tiny bit. Here I have my bullet lipstick. Here I have my lip glosses. It is a lot. So I'm going to split the video in two. I am going to move these two to the side. And we are going to focus on my liquid lipsticks today. And then my bullet lipsticks and my lip glosses will be a separate video. Because, yeah, it's just... otherwise, we will be here tomorrow. So that's not good. So let me move some stuff to the side for now. So I have the lippies here. And then I have three, well, baskets, whatever. One for declutter, one for keeping, and one for maybe. A little disclaimer. I know it's a lot. I know I have a lot of lippies. And please don't ask in the comment section if I will send you some. Because I will not. The lipsticks that I have unopened are actually just... I have one bullet lipstick and a gloss that are unopened that will probably be decluttered as well, which will be the next video. So those I will put in my giveaway pile. But you know, for the rest, it's going to friends and family. Why? Because everything I have here has been used. And I'm not going to send someone I don't know stuff that I use. Well... this kind of stuff, you know. I hope that makes sense. If you feel offended, your loss. But yeah, that's the way it's going to be. So let me start. It's probably going to be a long one anyway, because I want to swatch as well. You know, there's some stuff here that I haven't used in a while, so I just want to know how it is. So let's start with getting my makeup wipes ready, actually. Yes, so let me grab some. Okay, I have here NYX. Let me grab my NYX. Yeah, I think I have them all here. These are all liquid suede. I'm not really a fan of the formula, to be honest with you. These came all in lip sets and I got these because, well, people raved about the NYX, NYX formula. And they had liquid suede here, they had butter glosses here, they had lipsticks here, the turned up lipsticks. So I got sets from all and I have to say I'm not a particular fan of these. I don't really like the formula. So yeah, let me do this so I know what I do. Let me swatch them for you. So here is the color called Subversive Socialite. I do really, really like the color though. So I'm going to put this one aside because I just really like the color. Here I have Respect the Pink. It's not really for me. So it's going and I hope you can kind of see the colors. Here I have Initiator. And it's not really it either. So yes, it's going as well. This is Run the World. No. And then the last one is Sway. No, I'm going to do... the reason I'm holding on to this one is because I used it. This is the very dark one. I used it and it was really, really pretty. That's the only reason it's going in my maybe basket, which is actually this one. So, yes. So, the rest is... in the declutter pile. Next, let's go to this one from Revolution. I have a few of those as well. I should have a pink one somewhere. Ah, here. So I have three of these, and these were the... they came in a kit with a lip pencil. I don't remember what the kit was called. If I remember, I will put it in the screen. But I got these three colors. The pink one is called Grandi. It is a pretty color though. I just don't like the formula. So that's I find them very, very drying. It really does not dry down well on me. So it's going. And this is just such a unique color that I kind of don't want to get rid of it, you know? I'm going to keep that in a maybe pile as well. And here I have Regal, which is an orange. I have a color like this. And the formula that I have is better. So this one is going away. And next is... let's go to this one from 5050 Makeup. Maybe I need to shake this one. And this is the first liquid lipstick I tried from them. I love the brand. The color is also nice, only the problem that I have with this is the formula. The formula is like the one from Sleek, their Matte Me, that I have two of as well. I don't really like that formula. I am going to declutter this. I have the Matte Me here as well. I have another one. Ah, yeah. So I have two Matte Me's here from Sleek. This is Fandango Purple, this is Stonework. The colors are really pretty. They stay on for a very, very long time. It is just... yeah. I'm not a fan of the formula. The trouble is, though, that this color Stonework I so love. And I don't have a dupe. So, yeah. I'm going to declutter this one. I am going to hold on to this one just a tiny bit longer. I'm going to leave the swatch here. Because I'm hoping I have a dupe in my collection. Because I really, you know the trouble is, I love this color so much that I'm almost willing to kind of, you know, bear the formula, if that makes any sense. Let's go to these two next from L'Oreal. These are their Ultra Matte Liquid Lipsticks Le Chocolat. I have the colors. You see the color? Yeah. If I can hold them up to the camera, you can see the color. And it's probably the wrong way around, so I probably need to do it like this. Yes. I have 842 and 858. I love the colors. I just hate the formula with a passion. I tried this one yesterday, this one. Because I love the color so much, but the formula is just... it feels like I am putting melted chocolate on my lips. I don't like that. It takes quite a long time for them to dry down. They stay sticky during that time, and I cannot stand that. I would rather have it dry out my lips and dry down quickly than, you know, if it is a lip gloss kind of sticky, I don't mind it. But this is just the wrong kind of sticky. And oh Lord, I so hate this formula with a passion. So unfortunately, they have to go. If you do not mind this one, the Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink Formula, you won't mind these from L'Oreal. If you do not like this formula from Maybelline, you will definitely not like the formula from L'Oreal. Just so you know. Here I have the Maybelline Matte Ink Superstay in 15 Lover. I like the color a lot. I like it a lot. But again, the formula. Once it has dried down, it's okay. But for me to get there, same with these. It's just, no. So it's going. It's just a formula and that I cannot stand. Oh, I have almost nothing that I am going to keep. So let me pull out stuff that I'm definitely going to keep, which are my Jeffree Star lippies. I'm missing one. Where is it? Here it is. So here I have Jeffree Star lippies. As you can see, I have 5. I have here the color Flamethrower, which is new. I used it. I have here the color Wifey. I have Karma, which is the green. I have Self Control, which is the purple. And then I have here Can't Relate. Yes, I will swatch them for you. So here is Flamethrower, Wifey. But this is Self-Control. So here I have Karma and Can't Relate. They are staying. The formula is nice. It's not the best that I have. And so yeah, I had a problem with them skipping in the beginning. But now I kind of put them on a little bit differently. Instead of, making a big smile and then putting them on, I make a big smile, put them on. Then I relax my lips and put it on again, you know, go over it again. And that way I don't have skipping. So just so you know. Okay, I have here from L'Oreal 2 lip paints. This is the color Nudist and this is the color Off-White. The colors are really pretty. But again, the formula is just too thick. I don't particularly like this. So here, I like the color, but this color is not really pretty on me. So it's going. Here is the color Nudist, which is really pretty. I love this color very, very much. I am going to put this in the maybe pile and see if I can dupe it out with something else. Okay, now let's get you. These ones. Oh no, I need to sneeze in a minute. So I have 3 of these, which are new. Also from L'Oreal. This is the Rouge Signature. I have 3 of those in I Empower. I Achieve is the orange. I Empower is the light peach. And then I Stand is the brown. So let's start with the brown. Oh, these are not going anywhere, just so you know. The formula on these is really, really nice. So L'Oreal did good with these. This is a light formula. It dries down completely. It dries down pretty quickly. And they are nice. They are not heavy feeling like this one can be or these. You see, these are still tacky. I don't know if you can see that, but these were the chocolate things and they are still tacky. I don't like that. So here is the orange. I really, really think it is a very good formula. They did amazing with that one. So yeah, I highly recommend those lippies if you like the colors. Let's go to these two. I'm going to declutter these two as well from Kiko Milano. This is just a black, so yeah, I don't know why I'm not going to swatch that. It's just a black lipstick. This is 08. The color is okay on me, but the formula is not. I don't like this formula, so it's going. Let's do one that is staying. Let's do two that are staying. So here I have two from iHeart Revolution from the Mermaid line. The blue one is Deep Sea and this one is Siren. They're both metallic lipsticks, but when you, you first put them on, they look metallic. But when they dry down matte. And I'm actually quite sad about that. The formula is nice. There's nothing wrong with the formula. So they are staying. And especially this one, I had hoped would be metallic. But again, when it dries down matte. And I'm kind of sad about that, to be honest with you. Okay, next I have here from Max & More. It's also a metallic. It's Lip Lacquer Metallic in the color Burgundy Bite. Yeah, it's nice. It's pretty. It's not a bad formula. The formula is actually really comfortable. It's just the color I won't grab. So it's going. Oh, Lord. Okay. So I have here a Generation Matte from Catrice in Llama Pool. This one is not going anywhere. Just so you know. But I do want to kind of compare it to some shades. No, it's a little bit more purple. It's kind of a dupe for this one from L'Oreal, so that's good. So this one, the lip paint is going away because this one in Llama Pool is very, very close and this formula is very, very nice. I have a swatch video swatching all 10 shades of the new generation matte. Just so you know, I do lip swatches, I do finger or hand swatches, but this one, Llama Pool, is not going anywhere. It is very, very pretty. So let's go to these then. I have three. Four. So I have four. These are from AliExpress, from Miss Young. And they're actually quite nice. They're not bad. So I have the a black, which is color 10. I will link some lipsticks down below. Like, for instance, these from AliExpress. I will link them down below. I will link the seller that I got them from. I have some other lippies from AliExpress that I will link. You know, the one from 5050 Makeup I will link. I have one from Blush Tribe that I will link if I can still find the link. Those I will link, but the ones from the bigger brands, you know, like NYX and Catrice and Essence, I will not link. Jeffree Star, I will not link. Just because, you know, otherwise I will be here tomorrow. So, yeah. Unless I find myself having a lot of time on my hands, I will probably not link them. And if you want to know a specific shade that I kept, just ask and I will tell you. But a lot of these I have used multiple times. Okay, so this black is not a particular good black. You need to build this one up a little bit. But the formula is nice. And I am keeping it. And it was cheap as chips. So I'm keeping it. Then this is number 8. This is not the best formula that I have. But it is okay. And again, because of what I paid for them, I'm keeping them. So this one is kind of close. It's not the same, but close enough to the one from Maybelline. Here is number 11. So yeah, they can be a bit drying though, these. Just so you know. This is also very, very pretty. And this one is number 6. So yeah, this one is really pretty. This one just grabs my interest so much because it is a weird brown. But yeah. So, yes, okay. So let's grab other ones from AliExpress as well. I have 4 of these, I believe. Yeah. So I have 4 of these. These are from Poudrier. These are like the Sleek formula, but I actually think the Sleek formula is a little bit more comfortable. These are so drying. I will swatch them. This is number 14. I see people liking this formula though. I don't. It's too dry for me. You can very nicely sheer them out if you want to. The colors are pretty, but it's not for me. So this one is going. I have here number 4. And this color, I like this color so much. But yeah, I just really, really do not like the formula. I don't know if it translates well because if I look in my viewfinder, it looks brown, but it is orange. But yeah, it's going. Here I have number 2. which is a pinky nude, very pretty. But this one is also going, and the last one I have is number one. So yeah, what I'm going to do now though is clean my arm, or try to at least. Well, so some really do stay on very, very well. I'm actually drenching a makeup wipe in micellar water to help clean my arm. I am going to pause you for just a second while I kind of scrub my arm clean. So I am back with a clean arm, and I actually, well, it feels so soft because I think I have scrubbed. I just got some makeup remover, a balm, because yeah, I kind of needed something more heavy duty. So yeah, okay. Let's see, this one from Color Co. is really new. I haven't tried this on my lips yet. I did swatch it. The trouble is though that it kind of feels like the one from Sleek. Same kind of formula, so I don't know if I will like it. But it is staying because I just got it. And I have one here from Carity. Oh, it needs to go in the correct basket. Yes. Oh, I have two from Carity here. Two, the mattes. This one is in the color whatever. This one is in the color Matcha Gracias. And they are both new. I like both. I love this color. It's very, very pretty. So it's not going anywhere. This color, the green one, you need to kind of build up a bit. And build it up in light layers, because otherwise it can get gloopy really fast. Just so you know. Because it can be a little bit patchy, the green one, but it's not going anywhere. Okay, so let's grab this one, which is from Bella Pierre, a kiss-proof lip cream. This came in a box, in one of the Style Tone boxes. It's very expensive. I think this was, 24, 25 euros worth. That's what they say. Anyway, this is a metallic one. And this is really, really 90s. It's actually so bad, that color. I actually quite like it though. So yeah, I am going to keep hold of it for now. I don't know if it will make a round two when I next declutter my liquid lipsticks, but I could use this on my eyes, no problem as well. I don't know if I will get much use out of it, but for now it is staying. Next I have here from Blush Tribe, her liquid, this was the first liquid lipstick formula that she had. This is in the color 12. I don't know the color name though. It's a very pretty color. The formula of these is okay. It's not amazing. It is okay. So yeah, it is a bit sheer. You kind of need to build it up a little bit, but I'm going to put it in the maybe pile for now. Okay. I have here from ColourPop one of their ultra blotted lips. I got this actually sent to me by ColourPop because my order was delayed. So as an apology, they sent one of these lipsticks with them, or at least that's what the card said. This is in the color Party Wave. Unfortunately, I like the formula. I like the concept. I just don't like this color in this formula on me. So that is why I am going to pass it on. I worn it once or twice. No, I wore it twice. It's just not, I don't know, I don't like this color in that formulation. Just so you know. Okay. Here I have one from YSL. And this is one of the, is it a holographic? Yeah, holographic ones in the color 503. It's the most expensive one that I have, I think. Yeah, I got this sent to me by a friend from the UK. I haven't worn it a lot, and the reason for that is the smell. You can build this one up, you can do it sheer. The color is very, very pretty. Oh, but the smell is so, so strong. Why, YSL, why do you do that? But yeah, again, it's not going anywhere. Next I have this one, which I got around Halloween at Big Bazaar here. And it was just fun, you know, it's a metallic lip gloss, it has a skull on it, so, you know, just sometimes you just need that. And I actually like the color, the formula is not that bad either. I paid 1 euro for it, so I just, yeah. But I actually think the color is really pretty. So yeah, I will hold on to it for just a little while longer. Let me see where I have another one. Yeah. So here I have two from Primark. They came in a set of four. There were also two nudes in the set, but I wasn't into nudes when I bought this last year. So I gave the two nudes away and I kept the two reds because I was on a red lipstick kick at the time. They're not bad. It is just that the color isn't particularly it for me. But because these are minis and this is a drier formula, I usually combine one of these with one of my favorite red lip glosses that I have. I don't combine liquid lipsticks and glosses a lot, but with that red I do make an exception, otherwise it transfers like crazy. And with this one underneath, it is more true to its own color, and with this one underneath it gets a little bit darker. So I am holding on to these just for that reason only, because on its own it is just, I don't know, the color isn't it for me, you know? It just isn't it. Okay, so here I have one from Essence, a Color Boost Mad About Matte in the color 07 Seeing Red. The formula of these is very nice. It is just that the color, this color looks a bit, I don't know, plasticky on me. It's weird, but it is going. These two are the latest addition to the Essence Color Boost family. This one is the color Funk You. This is the color Partner in Crime. The formula of these is a little bit lacking compared to some of the other ones in the same line. The colors are really pretty though. So yeah, here are the colors. Usually I use this one with a lip gloss from Essence. And that combination works nicely. It's not so long staying then, but it works. These two are a little bit more drying than the other ones that I have in the Color Boost line. They are staying for now, at least. Okay, I have some other ones here as well from Essence. So let me move these to the side for now. Let me put these here and let me swatch them for you. This is the color 01 Dusty Romance, which is almost, I think, the same color as the one that I have from AliExpress. Oh no, not close. Never mind. But yeah, let me hold onto it for just a little while. And then let's get number two next, which is I Love You, Me Neither. Yeah, this was a little bit more of a pinky color. Then we have 03 Wanna Play. Yeah, I am going to declutter this one. Then we have Dangerously Yours, number 5. This one is really pretty. I just don't know what the formula is doing at the moment. Because I don't know if you can see, it is very, it looks like it's separating. So let me shake it. Maybe, I don't know. You know, the trouble is, I have no idea how long these have been in store. So maybe, I don't know, maybe they have gone bad. Let me smell. Ew, what the hell? Yeah, I am going to toss this one. I don't know what happened to it. I do like the color. It's a very pretty color. This is 05 Dangerously Yours. I just don't know what happened to it because it smells weird. So let me smell this one as well. No, they smell better than this one does. So yeah, I do like the colors of these. So I am going to keep them for a little while longer. I have here the color 09 Magnetic Gloom. So let me shake it first. Yeah, this color is pretty. It's almost the same as this one, only this one is lighter than this one. I do think it's really pretty though, so it can stay for now. Then let's go to all these from Catrice. I know I want to declutter some of these. Okay, so wait, let me put them in order first so I know what I'm doing, so I know I don't forget any. This is 1, 4, 7. Yeah, I had 100. I already put that one aside. Okay. So here I have them all. And number one is here. And I know number one isn't going anywhere because I like this one a lot. So, wait. Before I do that, let me clean my arm again. Before I cannot get rid of stuff. So now it's cleanish. Yes, okay. So let's go to number one, which is called Nude Town Express. I really like this one. This is a very, very, very pretty color. It's not going anywhere. 020, The Metalist. The reason I'm swatching them now, I'm going to speed swatch them, by the way, because again, I have my swatch video and they are in order. So this was number two. Then we go to number three, etc. So that I can kind of see which ones I want to keep and which ones I want to declutter. Okay, so I actually thought that I would declutter more. The only one I'm going to declutter is Girls Bite Back, which is number nine, which is this one. I think I'm going to declutter this one as well, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. It's number six, which is Blushed Pink, because I like 8 Pillow Fight better. So that one is going away again. This one I'm a little on the fence about, which is Exotic Rebel. I do like it. I'm not sure though. The trouble is, this is more of an autumn color for me. So, yeah. These I'm keeping. I do really, really like the formula though. I have here Magnetic Gloom from Essence again. Let me swatch it next to it. And kind of see which one I like better. Because I like the formula of the Catrice one better than the one from Essence. They are almost the same. So this one from Essence is going to go. And I'm going to keep the one from Catrice for now. So let's stay with Catrice. Because I have some more here. Okay. I actually think I'm going to get rid of most of these. So let's start with this one, which is Oriental Desert. I think I have something like this. Yeah. Yeah, I have something like this. I just wiped it away and I know I kept it. But this formula is really nice. And I know it was one from Essence. That is quite similar. Well, I like this one from Essence better than this one from Catrice. So the Essence one is staying. The one from Catrice, the Oriental Desert, is going to go. This one is in the color 20, I believe. I don't know. Because it has rubbed off. The formula on these is really nice though. Okay, so I'm going to get rid of that one from Essence, which was this one, I Love You Me Neither, and I'm keeping this one from Catrice. Because the colors are so similar, and I like the formulation from Catrice better. This is Mid Nude Season 010. I like this, but it you can't see it on my skin tone. When I put it on my lips, you cannot see it. So yeah, it's going. This one is 070 Into the Rosewoods. And it is very close to these. This one I kept, I think. Was it number 9 or did I declutter that one? I decluttered it, didn't I? Yeah. Fine. I'm going to declutter this one into the Rosewood. And I'm going to keep this one, which is Girls Bite Back, which was this one. Yeah, so the indecisive sometimes. This one is Sweet Choconut. Oh, and these are the Catrice Velvet Matte Lip Creams, by the way. It's a very pretty color. Let's keep it for now. Something like that. Okay, here I have a 100 Kind of Pumpkin. This one is a bit of a burnt orange. I actually think this one is really, really pretty in autumn. So I am holding on to it for now. Oh no, the other one is lip gloss. So here I have one from Wet n Wild. It's a liquid catsuit. I am actually not a fan. This one is in the color Nudist Peach. I don't really like this one. I like the color. I just think it's not a good formula. I don't think it's a good lipstick at all. To be honest, it could be the color. But yeah, I'm not a fan, unfortunately. So it's going to go. Here I have a Lipstick Transformer Matte from HEMA. And you can put this on your lips. And if you have a glossy liquid lipstick, it kind of makes it matte. So it's kind of a weird product. I used this in the hopes that I could get my Superstay matte ink to dry down faster, but it does not really work for that, so I don't have anything. It's going. You need to go somewhere else, by the way. So we're almost done. I have here two liquid catsuits or liquid linens from BH Cosmetics. The formula is really nice. Let's just start with that. So the formula of these is really nice. I love this light color. It does show up on me because it is opaque enough. It can stay. This was the color Natalie. Here I have the color Guliana, I think. I don't know. This one is... I've not really worn this one, to be honest. Because I just... I haven't done a look that I thought that it could be used with. But it is very, very pretty. So it's staying. It's a newer one. They are staying. The last one I have is a Hydra Matte in the color Night Rider from Gerard Cosmetics. Which is a very comfortable formula. It's just a weird one. Because it does dry down, but it kind of transferred as well, so it was weird. But the color is really, really pretty. It's almost the same color as this one from NYX. So this one, the Liquid Suede from NYX in Subverse of Socialite, is going to go. And I'm going to keep Night Rider. So the only thing I have left are these. I'm going to declutter the Blush Trap one. And I'm going to keep these two just because of the fact that the colors are so funky. And I don't have that. So, yeah. Let me wipe my arm off a little. It does not really help. I need to clean it. I need to scrub it. I know. But what I am going to do now is I'm going to count how many I kept. And how many I decluttered. And yeah. So let me do that. So I am decluttering 33. And I am keeping 42. I do want to weed it down a little bit more. So hold on. I went through everything again. I'm going to declutter a few extra. I'm also going to declutter these Velvet Matte lip creams in 090 Sweet Choconut from Catrice. And this one, the 020. I'm also going to declutter these two because if I'm being totally honest... Let me zoom in again. If I'm being totally honest, I can use my favorite red gloss on top of one of my red Jeffree Star lippies. And then I'm good as well. So I don't need to keep these two. So these are going. I went through my Generation Mattes as well. I am decluttering 090 Girls Bite Back. Danger Lips 050. 020 The Metalist. And 060 Blushed Pink. And you know, yeah, they are very pretty. The colors are pretty. The formula is really, really nice. But realistically, I'm just never wearing these. So they are going to go. So I'm decluttering 40. So yeah, let me move them all. So here is what I'm keeping. This one. And this is what I am getting rid of. These are my liquid lipsticks. So yeah, my dear sister, look at what you can pick from. It's a lot. Anyway... actually, I ended up grabbing 2, 4, 6 liquid lipsticks that I'm decluttering as well. Thank you so, so much for watching my liquid lipstick declutter. I hope you had fun. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comment section below. And yeah, I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I hope to see you soon for... part 2, which will be my bullet lipsticks and my glosses.